Good afternoon and welcome to one more webinar from Progress India. We conduct these webinars almost second, third and fourth Thursdays of every month. We try to bring in the goodness from the Progress softwares and then also any developer technology that's hot and latest and greatest. So we try to cover everything for developers. And then if you would like to be here next for our webinars, just bookmark URL that's been provided in your chat window, and then you will see the schedule being put up. We already have July, August schedule available now, so take a look at it. So I'm excited to talk about today's topic, building native mobile apps with Angular 2.0 and NativeScript. You know Angular, now you know mobile. I'm pretty sure most of you here today's webinar know about Angular, but I'm not going to be talking about Angular 1.x. So this is not Angular 1.x topic. We are looking specifically at Angular 2.0. I believe this is currently at RC, the release candidate. It is still not like a production ready, I believe, or go to production, but they have released it as an RC or a release candidate. So Angular 2 is interesting, and NativeScript is also interesting. I've been programming with NativeScript for quite some time now, almost a year now, and then I just simply love NativeScript because I'm reusing my skill. That's the whole point here with our NativeScript. So let's get started. If you're wondering who's behind the microphone or the voice, so my name is Lohit Jian. That's how I look, and my email ID is present there. I work as a technical evangelist with Progress in India. And that's my email ID. If you want to know, just send me an email and then we will be able to, talk to you and then help you out with whatever you're trying to do and then see what products of ours will be able to, make use of in your projects. So now this is the thing, NativeScript loves Angular, right? So that's the whole gist of this particular webinar, that's the whole agenda of this particular webinar. NativeScript loves Angular, and then we will see how we make it easy for you if you know Angular 2, how you can make use of your Angular 2 skills and then become a native mobile app developer, right? Today everything is about mobile apps. There is an app for that, right? That's the typical statement that you will hear, there's an app for that. So personally, my story is something like this. I have been a Windows developer for, since 2010, I believe, when Windows Phone Mango came out, and then I've been programming with Windows Phone, and I never jumped into Android or iOS. Simple reason, well, iOS, I do not have a Mac, and then I did not have the, flair to learn Objective-C or Xcode or anything, so I stayed away from programming for iOS. Then Android, yeah, well, it's fine. I know Java, but still the whole cumbersome steps to set up, the Eclipse, or now you have Android Studio, the emulator, that, this, everything. So it was not easier. Remember, I come from Visual Studio world, where you just open a Visual Studio, write the code, FI, that's it, done. I have a simulator out of the box, or I can plug in a device and then start working with that. So all I had to do was install Visual Studio. So having come from those experiences, I stayed away from Android and iOS. But when NativeScript came, everything changed for me. So the story is like, the whole point about NativeScript is like, hey, we do not want you to learn Objective-C. We do not want you to learn Java. We let you reuse whatever skills you know. The skills that you need for NativeScript is JavaScript. Well, I've been programming with JavaScript from, 2004. That's when I started with the thing. And once I know JavaScript, that's it. So with NativeScript, which is our framework or runtime, whatever you can call it, to build native mobile apps, we let you program or we let you develop in your own JavaScript. So basically you just need to know JavaScript, and then that's the developmental language for NativeScript. And of course Angular 2.0 came out new. As I said, I stayed away from Angular 1.x, but the moment Angular 2.0 came, I just wanted to go in and then try to see what is it. And I like the way Angular 2 has come out in terms of the components, in terms of how you can say like, here's the template URL. We'll see a couple of stuff. I'm not gonna go too deep today. We already have webinars available, you know, on our side, where we have talked about what is NativeScript, you know, like a level 100, getting started with NativeScript kind of webinars already available. We also done what is Angular 2.0, what's new with Angular 2.0. So I'm not going to go deep into these two terminologies, but keep in mind that, you know, today's talk is all about NativeScript and Angular 2.0. So starting from May 2015, every Tuesday, a lead developer from Google and a lead developer from our NativeScript used to meet, and they were trying to plan something, right? You know, we were planning to take over the world, you know, make the mobile domination or, you know, something like that. So basically, what we were trying to do was, this is the first entry from the Google Docs, you know, that our team, that my team and Google's Angular team got into, and then this is the first entry from that form. So if you look, I mean, from the doc, if you see here, the proposal that what we gave was, you know, Angular 2.0 disconnected itself from the DOM. They, Angular 1.x is tied to the DOM. But with Angular 2.0, what they did was they kind of segregated the renderer and the actual core Angular thing. So now that means anybody can come in and say like, hey, you know what, I will be the renderer, so I can write my own rendering. So that's the concept that we picked up. As you can see here, Angular renderer based on NativeScript view. So we wrote a DOM adapter, as we call it, for NativeScript, and Angular render compiler based on XML instead of the DOM. So Angular 2.0 segregated this concept of template, rendering, compiling, you know, all those things. So that's what we made use of that. If you see here, first example, the prototype, a proposal, what we have said was, in Angular 2, everything is a component, and then currently it's called as a template, but as you can see here, the initial version of Angular 2.0 had this concept of annotation called as view, and we would say like, you know, hey, the view for this component is so-and-so template. And what is a template? We just put a label. So that actually is a NativeScript label and NativeScript button, which will be rendered as a native Android label or native iOS label or, you know, button. And take a look at the proposal. The proposal was like, you know, of course, the tap on the button will be handled by a function called onTap. So this is how it was. The source code is there. The XML node tree will be, you know, compiled like this. Then there'll be Angular compiler ready and modify the node tree, and then Angular renderer. So instantiate and modify the NativeScript views. So this is the initial proposal that we had. And for those of you who are wondering as to, oh, what exactly was Angular 2 things, right? So Angular 2, this is what they did. They made it platform agnostic. So there's a markup, there's a DOM adapter, there's a compiler, there's a prototype, the views, and then of course there is a renderer, right? So what we did was basically currently in the Angular 2, you typically use HTML as a template, right? So what we did was we will use the our XML. NativeScript is all about XML syntax. And of course, there is a compiler, of course, there's a views, and then when it comes to renderer, we wrote our own renderer, which is nothing but the NativeScript renderer, right? And then, of course, all the other things that we did. So this is pretty much how we integrated with Angular 2. And in Angular 2, what Google did was, they said that Angular, you will need to use TypeScript to write code in Angular 2.0. It is not exactly vanilla JavaScript, but rather TypeScript is a superset of the JavaScript, and then you will compile the TypeScript into vanilla JavaScript, because you know, typically on a if you're going from a TypeScript perspective, it provides a lot of you know, goodness in the JavaScript. It provides you type safety, it provides you typings, it provides you generics, it provides the whole bunch of what do you call the features are available in TypeScript, and then that's what Google did. Google said that, okay, we're going to make TypeScript as the kind of the language that you will use in Angular 2.0. And so now, when with integration with NativeScript, yeah, you are programming with Angular 2 and TypeScript. That's it. So that's all you do. So this is an example of a NativeScript checkbox with Angular 2, right? So for those of you who are not familiar with Angular, this, I mean, TypeScript, this is how you import a particular module. So what I'm doing is, from a particular library called as Angular 2, I'm importing a module called as component, I'm importing a module called as event emitter. So in Angular 2, everything is a component, so you can create your own custom components too. So that's the beauty of Angular 2. So notice here what we have done. We said import component event emitter from Angular 2. Then what is the component? The selector. So on the tree, on the node, or the on the view tree, what is the selector for this particular component? Well, the selector name is checkbox. And inputs, meaning for this component, what are the properties that this exposes that somebody from outside can set it? So we, in our case, it's checked. And then outputs, meaning what does this particular component allow outside guys to take advantage of? So in this case, I'm exposing a property or event called as tap. So if I expose this event called as tap, somebody from outside can say like, hey, when the tap happens, here is my handler. I want you to execute that my handler. So all we are doing is it's basically, as you know, in Android or anywhere, there's no checkboxes in the mobile world. The checkbox is in the web world, right? So in order to create a simple checkbox kind of effect, what we are doing here is we use the image. There's a checkbox checked image, and then there's a checkbox unchecked image. So if the property checked is true, I'm going to use checked. If the property is false, I'm going to use unchecked. And it is using a CSS class, so that's another thing. In native script, you do not have to worry about anything to style. Rather, if you know CSS, you will be able to style your components. In this case, I've written a style sheet called a style class called as checkbox. And then notice how we are making use of Angular 2's syntax. Like, you know, the square bracket around src is nothing but in Angular 2, any property that you want to data bind, you put it inside a square brackets. Then in the case of the tap, what is happening is tap is an event. So any event that you want to execute or any function that you want to execute, you basically put it in between the parentheses or the brackets, as we call it. And I'm calling on tap, right? So how is the code for this? Well, as simple as this. Export class checkbox, public tap event emitter, and then public checked boolean. So that's what I said. So I'm exposing tap, I'm exposing checked, and notice here what is happening. Public dot on tap, I'm just doing this dot tap dot next, this dot check. So I'm passing whether the condition, the state of checked, what was it? Is it a true or a false? To whoever is listening to the onTap method, or whoever is listening to the onTap event. That's all, that is as simple as it can get. So this is what you can do with Angular 2, and this is a native mobile app component that we just created, right? I know it's gonna be looking a little bit of Greek and Latin, don't worry about that. We already have webinars which talk about what is Angular 2, I mean, new things in Angular 2 and the new, what is native script. So maybe at the end of this webinar, when I write the recap blog post, I'll put a link to those webinars, and then you can watch that and then come back and then, you know, understand what is going on here. So now the question is, what is NativeScript, right? So basically, a NativeScript is a open is an open source framework for building truly native mobile apps with JavaScript. Now, hang on. Before you go and say like, oh, JavaScript, oh, that means DOM. No. That's what we are trying to say. We are saying truly native mobile applications. Remember, JavaScript is just a language. For example, if you are using JavaScript to create a Node.js based server API, where is the DOM there, right? There's no DOM, right? Similarly, what we have done is we have created a framework, we have created a library called as NativeScript, which allows you to build truly native mobile apps, and the development language is JavaScript. Right? You can use your web skills like TypeScript, Angular, CSS, and get native UI and performance on iOS and Android. So that is what the whole benefit you get with NativeScript. You can reuse your skills that you have already learned. You do not have to learn Objective-C. You do not have to learn Java. All you need is, do you know TypeScript? Do you know Angular? Do you know CSS? Yeah, well, you know how to create a native mobile app. So with NativeScript, what we provide you is a bunch of components, or what we call it as modules. So a button, a label, a grid layout, a stack layout, these are all the bare minimum modules that we have already built in NativeScript, which you can readily use it. So if you use a label from NativeScript modules, when you package your app, run it on Android, it will be android.widget.label. And you package it for iOS and run it on an iPhone or iPad, it will be whatever NS. The namespace, whatever you have on the iOS side. So that's what it is. It's an open source framework for building truly native mobile apps with JavaScript. You can use your web skills like TypeScript, Angular, and CSS, get native UI and performance on iOS and Android, right? So the difference, what is the difference? So where do we stand apart from anybody, right? The NativeScript difference, right? So rich, animated, no compromise, native UI, right? So that's the first thing. It's all about native UI. We are not putting, you know, people, the moment we say JavaScript, people say, oh, this is a hybrid app, so there is a phone gap thing coming up, or there is a web view coming up. No, this has got nothing to do with a DOM. This has got nothing to do with a web view. This is pure native UI that you get. So as I said, search for examples NativeScript in the iOS App Store or Google Play to try this out for yourself. So we have a NativeScript kitchen sink demo app, or you know, kitchen sink is nothing but kind of a demo application where we showcase the power of NativeScript. So if you go to your Android store or if you go to your iTunes and search for examples NativeScript, you will find a demo app which is built using NativeScript. So you can check the power for yourself. Sorry, I think I went tired. So, and then maximum code and skill reusability. So, basically, there's a guy called as Nathan Walker. He is the one of the most active member that I've seen on, you know, NativeScript community. There are a bunch of them. But Nathan Walker, what he did was he created something called as Angular 2 Seed, Angular 2 NativeScript Seed project. So, what you're seeing there is the same NativeScript based, NativeScript plus Angular 2 based code, which is running in the UI, that is on a browser, which is running on an Android, which is running on an iPhone. That's the power of NativeScript, since NativeScript and Angular 2. Since Angular 2 provides you this concept of, you know, you can have different renderer for different platform because the renderer is platform agnostic, what he did was he created a project wherein you can write all the shared code logic in Angular 2, right? For example, you have a model, you have a service, the service goes out to the HTTP, so you can use the Angular HTTP library, gets the data, massages the data, whatever it is. But when it comes to UI, maybe you will use NativeScript for native mobile apps, and then you will use a vanilla HTML for the browser. You can do that. That's possible because Angular 2 makes it agnostic, the platform agnostic rendering. So this is a fantastic thing that Nathan Walker has done. Big shout out to him. And then first class Angular and TypeScript support. Within NativeScript, the TypeScript and Angular are first class citizens, right? You know, you can program with either just the TypeScript, or I'm excited to see you know, people working on the Angular 2 and the NativeScript. It's a completely different experience altogether. So that's what we give you with NativeScript, and this is what it is, native Angular emblem. And we already have, you know, this is the, it is already there in our nativescript.org, the website, if you go there. So take a look at this application that we have. We call it as Grocery App. There is an Android version, there's an iOS version, and also there's a web version. And then it's all having one solution, and then we just have the rendering portion different for NativeScript and then for the web. But all the other things, we just share it. You know, authenticating a user, getting the data from somewhere, all those core logics is shared across all these projects. And just to give you, you know, a couple of things. One is we give you 100% access to Android and iOS APIs from your JavaScript. So if you are coming from an iOS, you know, platform perspective, iOS has this concept of, you know, I mean, it has this API called as UI Alert View. That's the pop-up that you get, or the alert message that you get. So we already have certain dialog modules available. We have abstracted out the Android behavior. We have abstracted out the iOS behavior. And then if you just use our dialog module, you do not have to worry what is it on Android, what is it on iOS. We will do it for you. But let's say you want to take control and you would like to basically call some API, native API, right? So yeah, you can do that. If you see here, in your JavaScript, you can always say UI alert view, and that is actually a iOS API, and then you can do this, and then take a look at this alert.add button with title, alert.show, everything. Similarly, if you want to go and then do a lot of other stuff, you can do it. As you can see here, you can do android.text.format.time, you know, all those things, you can do it. You can call the native APIs, runs on V8 in JavaScript VM, runs on JavaScript Core VM. So basically what we do in NativeScript is, in order to execute your JavaScript, we bundle the virtual machines. If you're building an Android package, we bundle the V8. And then if you're building a iOS package, we bundle the JavaScript core. Well, how does it work? Basically, as I said, is these are all the JavaScript engine, WebKit engine, and this is what happens when you say, so there you go, when you do java.io.file, we will do the conversions on our end. We know that it's a java.lang.string, we know that it's a java.io.file, and you can always create the, call the file handler. So what do, how do we do this? Well, basically we take care of the metadata generation, meaning the whole API, whatever you have, will be packed into your packaging, and then we at runtime we cannot keep on reflecting on, okay, what does JavaScript statement called java.file.io.file, what does it match to in the native world, right? So that's the metadata we already pack it, and at runtime we smartly cache all these calls that's been going on, and then we don't spend too much time on reflection. Rather, we know that, okay, if this is the call that's been made in JavaScript, that maps to so and so native call. So if you say, like, I don't want to write iOS and Android code, well, we don't need you to do that. So that's where NativeScript modules for all the things are available. So so we call it as NativeScript modules. So the code is in JavaScript, and that is nothing but you make use of the modules, right? We have a module for label, we have a module for button. So if you want to create a UI and then you want to use a button, all you need to do is use our NativeScript button module. That's it. And we will make sure that when you package it for Android and run it on an Android device, we know what button it has to come there. It's android.widget.button. If you're running it on an iOS, we know what button has to come on an iOS. But for you as a developer, you do not have to worry about those, the platform specific things. We have given you a bunch of modules available, and the community is so active that they're writing a lot of modules day in and day out. And you name it, so there is a module for that that the community has written. So that's what it is. So within your code, you will make use of your modules, and then the modules will know how to render themselves on a very specific platform. So this is an example, one UI syntax for all. Take a look at this. I want to have a switch button on a screen, right? So what we have done is we have created the switch module. So this is the NativeScript native module, and you just have to use this UI in an XML. So in our case, the UI is written in XML. So in the XML, if you put a switch, that is all it is. So we know what is a switch on Android, what is a switch on iOS. So that's what the NativeScript modules is all about. And not only that, we have given you a couple of core modules like this. For example, if you want to work with a file, right, it's pretty interesting concept here. I mean, the whole scenario of I want to store a file on the device, right? So you're talking about Android, which is a completely different operating system. You're talking about iOS, which is a completely different operating system. The file system themselves are different. So what do you do? Well, you don't have to worry. We already have created something called as a file module. So all you do is import file from file system. So that's the module. And now you can just say new file.save, whatever you want to do. So this is the higher level abstraction that we give you, and then we know what to do on a very specific platform. So this is what we do on a Android. We will do new java.io.file on a I don't know how people remember all these namespace things in iOS. As you can see here, you need to first grab nsfilemanager.defaultmanager, then you have to say create file at path content attributes blah blah blah, right? That's what it is in iOS. But that's what you get. So, and these are the modules that we have as of now. Application module, the camera, the color, again, color, two different APIs on Android and then on the iOS, but we give you a NativeScript module, which you just program against one. So these are some of the modules that we have, and this is another thing. We also, this is within NativeScript, so if you want to use with our NativeScript module, you can do it, but I will show you that in NativeScript plus Angular 2, Angular 2 has its own HTTP library, so you're free to use either ours or the Angular one. It's up to you, but I'm just showcasing what NativeScript provides. So within NativeScript, we have a HTTP module where you just say HTTP is equal to require HTTP, and then you say get JSON, then you know, that's it, right? So here's the big picture. If you have XML HTTP request, which is a NativeScript module, so it will do a native Android call, it will do a native iOS call, and then it's basically on an iOS app or on an Android app. That's the abstraction layer that we created. Now, what happens is, because Angular 2 is coming, so Angular 2 also has an HTTP module, and then what it will do is it will piggyback on our NativeScript module. And if you are running the same code on a browser, meaning on a web browser, so it will make use of the XML HTTP request. But when you are using Angular 2 within our native script, it piggybacks onto our module, because you know, we know what to do on a platform, very specific platforms, right? There's a question, why Windows app is not included in native script? Well, we are not yet ready for the Windows app, so that's why we have not put it up yet, but there's already an experiment going on with our engineering team. They already created the first bare-bone version of you know, native script on Windows 10 universal platform, you know, on a UWP app, converting a native script as an UWP app. We won't be doing Windows Phone 8 or Windows Phone 8.1 binary, but rather now it is all about UWP. So what we will do at the end of the year is provide, you know, we will know how close we are to actually make it work. So for example, one source code using NativeScript, and the output can be generated for Android, output can be generated for iOS, which is the case today, and we will also be able to generate an output for Windows 10 UWP. So that's still in the works. That as I speak, the team is experimenting, the team is kind of cranking on how to make this happen. So it uses the AJAX call, and then you get the web app, right? So that's the big picture. And then this is the important thing. In Angular 2, the complete changes, the change from how you use in Angular 1.x to 2 is some of these things. For example, if you want to bind any attributes of an element, you know, for example, there is an input, in our case, in NativeScript, I have a label component or label module, and label module has a text attribute. So if I want to bind the text attribute with a, you know, property from my component, all I need to do is a square bracket and the attribute name, and then the event binding. Any event, you will have to put it in the parenthesis. Then intercepting input, so maybe you want to create a local variable within your Angular 2 views, right? So you can do a hash and then put something that will become the intercepting input, you know, pretty similar to what you used to do in 1.x, where you would say ng model or something like that. Then condition, so Angular 2 has this conditional attribute or directive called a star ng if, wherein I can have a particular element, and then if I want to check, I mean, if I want to show whether it is available or not, or you want to do, I can do an ng if condition and then say like, hey, if this condition is true, show this particular element, right? And then looping, it has a star ng for is equal to expression, and then you just use it. Styling, you can do, this is interesting. Let's say I want to have a different styling for checked, I want to have a different styling for unchecked, right? So with Angular 2, now it's very easier. I can just say class.checked is equal to, let's say, a condition like we are doing a to-do, let's say we are doing a to-do item. So item.completed, and then class.unchecked is equal to not to-do.completed. If the to-do item is not completed, show the unchecked. If the to-do item is completed, show the check. So like that. So this is the bare minimum things that you will need to know with Angular 2. Attribute binding, event binding, conditions, loops, and then styling. This is how Angular 2 you know, works. And CSS. So the better thing about NativeScript is, like, you know, I've done a couple of Android related stuff, and then In Android, the way you create styling for your app is through an XML file, right? You know, of course, I'm not saying it's bad, but having come from the web world, we know how easy it is to write a style sheet, right? You know, basically you will just go ahead, create a class and then say like, you know, all these things, color, font size, width, margin, all those stuff. With NativeScript, we allow you to do this. So label is, as you can see, does not have a dot as the starting one. That's because I'm applying it to a inbuilt module called as label. So anywhere in my app, there's a label. Now it's going to have a red color foreground, and then it will be font size 20, the width will be 200, and it will have a margin of 20. So this is how easy we make it for you to develop your native mobile apps with your skills that you can reuse. I talked about JavaScript, now I'm talking about CSS. So your whole app can be styled using just this CSS concept. And of course, we don't so we don't have a full set of the CSS that we support, but there are certain things that we cannot translate into the native world, so that's why we have a complete list about these supported styling properties, as you can see here. So you can go take a look at it, and then we support pretty much most of the bare bone that you need. For example, the margin, the padding, font colors, the font size, background color, color, border, all those typical things that you need is supported. So the difference is in the UI. Web UI is not equal to mobile, right? So that's what it is. So we have a lot of layouts for you, absolute, dock, grid, stack, all those things. So now let's get going. So as I said, I will not be, you know, kind of taking a class on how to start with NativeScript. I suggest you go and then take a look at our previous webinar. So what I'm going to do now is, okay, let me, so I already have NativeScript you know, installed on my machine. So in order to install NativeScript, what you can do is you can always go to nativescript.org. So for example, here is nativescript.org. So if you go to nativescript.org, that's the you know, website for NativeScript. And if you click on developers and then documentation, there is a section which talks about installation. How do you get NativeScript on your system? So depending on what platform you are on, for example, I'm on Windows today, so I followed the Windows installation. If you're on OS X, so meaning Macintosh, or you are on Linux, so we have a different installation instruction. So I have gone ahead and then followed this Windows instruction here. If you see here, Windows 7 Service Pack 1 or later, so meaning you can develop it, start from Windows 7, 8, and now 10. So I'm on 10. You will need the Node.js. So I've already installed the Node.js. You will need the JDK. You'll need the Android SDK. And then you will need the Android SDK build tools. And keep in mind that on a Windows machine, so NativeScript supports Android and iOS, but if your developmental machine is Windows, you cannot create a iOS package. That's how Apple does it. So right, you know, you can create an iOS package only on a you know, Mac machine, right? So since I am on a Windows machine, what, if you see our instruction, you can only install Android, because you know, Android can be installed anywhere. It can be installed on a Mac, or it can be installed on a Windows. So on although NativeScript supports Android and iOS, if I am using a Windows laptop, I can only do a build, or I can do a packaging of only Android. So that's what we're going to see today. I already have an Android device with me. Let me start mirroring. So as you can see, I have a Nexus 7 connected. So it's coming up now. And there we go. So this is my Nexus 7 that I have. So it's mirrored, so let's keep it aside. And I have all, followed all these things, and then I've already installed you know, all those things. If you see here, we let you know what needs to be done all those things. And then finally, how do you install NativeScript? Well, NativeScript does not have any UI. It's just a library framework, right? So it's a runtime. So what is the relationship between Telerik and NativeScript? Well, Telerik is the company which has developed or which has manufactured this framework or runtime called as NativeScript. So NativeScript is our baby, but NativeScript is, we have released NativeScript as an open source software. So what you will need to do is, all you need to do is you just have to say npm -i-g NativeScript. For those of you who don't know what this is saying, hey, Node package manager, install this package called as NativeScript globally, meaning at any, you know, I should be able to run NativeScript from any command prompt within my system. So globally make it available. And now what I can do is, as you can see here, it is saying TNS doctor, but I will say TNS -- version. So TNS is the short form for Telerik NativeScript. So our CLI, NativeScript CLI, uses this TNS jargon or TNS command. So if you do a TNS, now you will see a bunch of things coming up. There we go. So this is what we give you. So TNS has this alias, or you can do NativeScript. Both works, but I like using TNS. And then commands, what commands are available? You can do a create, you can do a platform add, you can do a platform list, platform remove, all those things. So in the interest of the time, what I'm going to do is I'm going to quickly create. And by the way, I've not talked anything about Angular 2 or anything. As I said, the webinar is not about Angular 2 deep dive, but I'm assuming you will go look it up. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go one level up, and I will say TNS create ng or ns ng2 app, and I'm going to use something called as a flag which tells NativeScript that, hey, you know what, I want you to create the project based on Angular 2. So we just have a short circuit thing saying, like, you know, it's a short alias which is like -ng. So the moment I do this, what Telerik NativeScript will do is it's going to go ahead, create me an app, but base it on completely base it on the Angular 2. I'll show you the code. So let's wait for this couple of seconds. In the meantime, I'm going to start looking at some of the questions. How to apply different colors to different labels in single native application? Well, different labels means different class, CSS class that you create, and then you attribute those class to the different labels. So label class is equal to class 1, label class is equal to class 2, so like that. So this is going to go ahead and then create. If it takes more time, it is trying to go to the NPM registry and then trying to bring down a whole lot of things. So if it's going to go slow down, I'll show you already a demo app that I've built. So for code editor, I can use, what code editor I can use for NativeScript? As I said, NativeScript is all about the framework of the runtime and the files that you author in NativeScript is an XML file or a CSS file or a JavaScript file. So you can use any code editor that you are familiar with. I'm going to be using one of the coolest editor that I know of. That's the Visual Studio Code. If you are a JavaScript guy, you got to know about Visual Studio Code, fantastic code editor, and then that's what I will be using. Can we use Angular plus NativeScript for Windows Mobile? Not at the moment. We are not yet ready for Windows Mobile. By WP, I mean .NET web pages. Well, .NET web pages and mobile apps are two different things. On a .NET, ASP.NET web application, yes, you can use Angular 2 as a front end. I think I covered most of those things. How do you support SVG and Canvas in NativeScript? I'm not sure why would you need an SVG or a Canvas in NativeScript when you are right there on the metal, right? You do not need an SVG. As I said, we are not giving you a web UI, a web view. I'm going to showcase in just a moment. You will see that it is a pure native UI. So you already have all the native, whatever you want to do on the native you know, the framework, and then you're right on the metal, so you can pretty much do whatever you want there. So you don't need a canvas, you don't need a SVG. So as you can see, looks like my machine is running low on some resources, so it's taking a little bit of time. And we should be, yeah, there we go. So we have now created the application. So I'm going to do cd nsng2app. And now what we need to do is, remember I talked about NativeScript can support Android and iOS. So we need to add the platform to my application. So I will say TNS platform add Android. I can add only Android because I am on a Windows laptop. And on a Windows laptop, you cannot add an iOS platform. So what you can do is you can take the same source code, put it into your GitHub, open up a Mac, clone the project, and from the Mac, you can say TNS platform add iOS, and then now it will add iOS support to your project. And of course, building an iOS will have to be done on a Mac. But on a Windows, you can always do a package for Android. So that's what I'm going to be doing now. So what it is doing is it's doing a bunch of things now. We have a couple of things that we do. Can we use NativeScript with AngularJS 1.5? Nope. As I said, this even if you take a look at our title of this webinar, this is NativeScript plus Angular 2.0. That is because Angular 2.0 makes it possible for you to integrate to the view layer because the view rendering is platform agnostic. Whereas 1.5 or 1.x, it sticks to the DOM. You know, it is tightly coupled to the DOM. Angular 1.x needs DOM. How many types of starter projects supported as of now? Well, there are a bunch of templates available, so you can start taking a look at it. So there is a barebone template that I created. There is a master detail template. And then we have a bunch of other examples that people have done. Let me show you this one example where, this is the sample, this is NativeScript plus Angular 2 to-do MVC app that one of our team member has written. So you can always go clone this particular project, take a look at how it was done in all those things. So let's see if it is done. No, it is still installing. Can we use NativeScript with ASP.NET MVC project? I'm not sure if I have made myself clear. This is used for creating native mobile applications with JavaScript as a development language. So this has got nothing to do with ASP.NET MVC because ASP.NET MVC is a web project. What I'm talking about is how do you create cross-platform native mobile application with single source code, with single team, with single feature that you can write, and then it goes everywhere. So that's what NativeScript allows you to do. So now we have added the platform. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and then use my editor. So I'm using code, or Visual Studio Code. So I'm going to say code dot, and then that will be like that. There's a question, TypeScript versus NativeScript, what's the difference? So, well, NativeScript is the runtime or the framework. TypeScript is a language. Does it cover all native features of a device? Absolutely. We provide you the complete native APIs that you need within NativeScript. So, this is the, basically, if you take a look at here, so this is the project, or this is how the project looks like. There's an app folder, there's a hooks folder, there's a node module, there's a platform, there's a package.json, and then of course we need the tsconfig.json because we are working with TypeScript. This is a TypeScript configuration. So where is the code? The code is all here. Everything starts from here, main.ts, right? So let me zoom out a little. So notice here, this is what we allow you to do. Let me minimize this guy. Import NativeScript bootstrap from NativeScript Angular application. So this is what we provide you. We need a different bootstrap. So Angular 2 is based on bootstrapping, and Angular 2 for the browser has its own bootstrap. So what we did was we wrote our own for NativeScript. And I have my component here. So this is the main component in my application. So what I'm going to do is, let me zoom out. And so what it is doing is, it is saying like, hey, when the mobile application starts, I want you to bootstrap, or I want you to start, and then this is the starting component, or this is the main page, right? So let's take a look at app.component.ts. Notice here in Angular, everything, okay, let me increase the font. Hopefully now you should be able to see it clearly. Yeah, there we go. So in Angular 2, everything is a component, and you need this component available in Angular/core. So you need it from there. So I'm saying, okay, give me that. Then this is known as in ECMAScript 6 or ECMAScript 7, I think this is going to be standardized. These are known as annotation on your classes. So I'm saying, hey, this is a component. And this component is nothing but, it's having a template. So the UI of this component is available here, app.component.html. But the logic is here. So what is the logic? So the logic is fairly simple. Yeah, so annotation or decorator, so you can pretty much call it any way you like it. So I believe it's called as a annotation or decorator, whatever. So what I'm doing is, I'm saying like, you know, hey, this is my component. The component's UI is going to come from here, app.component.html, and then it has a counter, and I have a property here called as message. So if the counter is greater than 0, I will say taps left. Otherwise, I will say, hooray, you're ready to start, right? And then notice here, I have a on tap, and I'm just decreasing the counter, right? And if I go and then take a look at the app.component.html, this is native script UI for you. So take a look at this. Although this is HTML, but what we are doing is, we created a native script module called a stack layout, and then this is a native script label, and this is a native script button, and this is a native script label again. And notice what I'm doing. So this is just a tap the button, just a you know, informational message. And this is what I was talking about. I'm just calling class is equal to title. So if you're coming from web background, you know that in the web, you will just say class is equal to so and so. So where is this style sheet class then? Well, it's available in app.css, right? So take a look at this here. So I have this title. So what I did was, I said font size 30 and margin 20. Let's go back to the component.html, and I have a button, and notice here the button exposes a tap event. So I'm just saying tap, and it will be handled by this function called as on tap. And remember the attribute binding, so label has an attribute called as text. So basically you will bind the text attribute to the message property of the component. You know, it's like my model. And of course, this also has a class style sheet applied for this. So now, in order to run this, what we will need to do is go back to, okay, let me resize this guy. And I will bring up my mirror of the device that I have. So now, in order to run, it's fairly a simple command. We can just say like TNS run Android, and I don't have to specify anything because the Telerik native script runtime will know that there is a connected device, and then pretty much it will build the package, the Android APK, and then push it onto the device. So that's what I'm going to do now. So by the time it takes, so the first ever build is going to take like a minute or so. So I've just started the build now. I've said TNS run Android, so it's going to build and then push it onto the Android device. So let me take a couple of questions. This is which editor? I'm using Visual Studio Code. That's one of the best editors that I know of now for JavaScript. How will we come to know the different attributes in ngscript? Well, you can go to the ngscript, meaning the Angular 2. Well, that would be the angular.io. That's the new website for Angular 2 documentation. You'll need to go there, you know, kind of read through. That's what I said. We already done a couple of webinars. We have done one webinar which talks about Angular 2, what's new. So you can take a look at that and then do that. And then does live reload supported? Yes, we do have a live reload. I'm just doing it for the first time. I want to completely create it, push it onto the device, and then I will show you the live reload. Can I set breakpoints in my code and debug? Yes, we have an integration with Visual Studio Code. Let me show you some of the extension that we have installed. So this is the extension that you need. If you see here on my So if you see here, we have NativeScript support for Visual Studio Code. So if you install Visual Studio Code, you can directly run from Visual Studio Code and you can put a breakpoint and then debug right from the Visual Studio Code. If not, our TNS command line has a debug command where it will break at very specific breakpoints that you have set up, and then it will start showing you a different debugging UI. Like Cordova, do we need any plugins? Of course, we cannot create everything. So what we have done is, like, if I show you the NativeScript, and if I go to components here, so these are the components that are available out of the box. But if you go to npmjs.com and search for NativeScript, you will get a bunch of components that the plugins, as we call it, or a module, as we call it, being created by the community. So out of the box, these are the some of the components that we provide. And keep in mind that any native API, you can always go and then interact with it through your JavaScript code. How natively NativeScript as compared with Xamarin? We are completely native. I'm not sure what do you mean by how natively NativeScript as compared with Xamarin. It's the same. I mean, with NativeScript, what we do is we take all your JavaScript, we create, the UI is generated completely native. The JavaScript is executed using the virtual machine. You know, they bundle, I believe the runtime, the Dalvik runtime, all those things, they bundle it along with your application. So similarly, we bundle the virtual machine because we need to execute the JavaScript. Is Visual Studio Code open source? Absolutely, Visual Studio Code is an open source editor. And the build has been succeeded, so it's 1 minute and 17 seconds, but it's still not yet, the APK is not yet ready, so it's now going to create the APK and then push it, so just give me a couple of time. There's a question, does TS support background processing? I'm assuming you're talking about, does TypeScript support background processing? Well, TypeScript is just a language. It has got nothing to do with background processing or anything. On our runtime, yes, we do have a couple of plugins which allow you to, spin off a thread and then do something in the background. Do we need to add any plugin in VS Code to see the reference of Angular 2? I'm not sure I understand what you mean by reference of Angular 2. Oh, NS support background processing? Well, yes and no. Basically, at the moment, you will need to use a plugin which will allow you to do background processing. There's a plugin that a community member has written. It's not out of the box. So sorry about this, it's still running. It's going to take a couple of time. I've already eaten up the 1 hour mark. So let me just go ahead and then make sure this is... Okay, it's going to take a little bit of more time. This is the first time it is building it, and I have a GoToMeeting running. I have Visual Studio Code running. So there are a lot of things happening on my machine. So looks like my machine is running low on memory. But yeah, we should be able to get it back. Is it only for mobile app development? Absolutely. So this is all, this native script is for developing native mobile apps, but reusing your skills, which is JavaScript, CSS, XML. Can you please share Git URL for this app? Well, I'm not sure I understand the question. Basically, you just have to install the, if you go to nativescript.org, it has information on how to install it. And what you do is you just do a TNS create and provide --ng. Are you using any specific emulator for this? No, I'm actually running a device which is next to me, next to my laptop. I'm doing a mirroring of this. The right-hand side, what you're seeing is a mirror of that. I'm not sure why this guy has hung. So let me, somebody asked for live reload. So we have a command called as live sync, and I can say TNS live sync watch, meaning hey, keep watching for any file changes, and then I want you to if there is a change, I want you to reload. So, and then I also set device one, so meaning there is I want you to push the APK or push the package onto a device with ID 1, so I know my device ID is 1. Can NativeScript access all basic native functionality for both iOS and Android? Absolutely, anything that there in the native API, you can call it from the JavaScript, NativeScript JavaScript. What are the advantages of NS compared to phone gap? It's like apple to oranges. Phone gap is hybrid mobile application. That means there is a web browser and you're writing HTML, and then the HTML is getting rendered on the browser, and it is going to be buggy, I mean little bit laggy, not buggy, but it depends on what you need. Do you need the native performance? You need a native mobile app. So that's what NativeScript is providing you. It provides you native mobile app, but you do not have to learn iOS, you do not have to learn Java, you just need to know JavaScript, and then you will be able to create mobile app, native mobile app. So it's gonna taking a couple of minutes, so in the meantime, what I can do is, so you saw this example, so let me show you a real world the sample to do MVC that are, let's see if it's gonna come back. Let's give it a couple of more seconds. In the meantime, I'm going to see if there are more questions, but I hope you understood the concept here. So with NativeScript, what happens is you just create here is the component. So this is the Angular 2, somebody is saying I'm not able to get a recording of the earlier webinars, please help, please visit telerikhelper.net. We have all the previous webinars we're recording there. So in NativeScript and Angular 2, everything is a component. So this is what the component that we have written. So there you go. So here's the component. Here's the code that's being written on the component. And the component will have a UI. So you get the UI. So UI, as I said, there are a bunch of things available on the UI, I mean as a component. If I go back to the NativeScript, and there you go, so you can use a button, label, text wheel, text view, search bar, switch, slider, progress, activity indicator, list view, we do have web view, we do have tab view, segmented bar, date picker, time picker, list picker, dialogue, so you name it. So everything is provided. So let me see if it got built. Okay, it knows that it is not installed, so it's now going and then trying to do some things on the device itself. Not sure why it's taking so much time. Looks like my machine is super loaded. Let me go back to the code. So this is the, so now I can just come in and then add any UI element that I can that I need. For example, I showed you a lot of UI elements here, text view, search bar, switch, slider, list view, you name it, you can pretty much do it here. I mean, you can come in and then create any component like this. So every component is just a XML tag. And at runtime, we know how to convert this into the actual UI. For example, the button that you have here, so it's connected to something. So let me see if I can show you some examples that I've already created. Okay, so I think I have... well, this is an application that I've been working on for quite some time now. It's called as Indie News. The idea is, I'm listening, or I'm going and then pinging a particular web service which will provide a different news related to India. For example, if you see here on a national level, so I have featured news, then I have a crime news. So as you can see here, I have the crime news now coming up. And there we go, so we have the crime news. Notice here how neatly I can by the way, all this is done using CSS. The styling, that whatever you're seeing is completely CSS. I put the style, font size, font height, color, all those things, you know. And then this is actually a card in Android. There is something called as a card view. So I'm using a card view. Some community member wrote that particular card view, and I'm using that. So that's a plugin that I'm using within this one. So politics. So I change the tab. So this is a segmented bar, and sorry, not segmented bar. This is a tab view. So I change the tab. I make a call to the service wherever I'm listening to. I get the data and then I paint it. And notice here we have a okay, it's powered by Yahoo. So I have a site drawer coming up, and I can say, okay, show me science and technology, and it goes to the science and technology. Here's the internet related news, mobile related news, and there's a science related news. And what's interesting is one of the community member, he created a plugin to use Chrome tab or Chrome tab or a Chrome view, as it's called as. So if I now click on this particular item, you will notice here that I am not opening up a web view. You know, typically you would see people opening up a web view. This is not a web view. This is a Chrome tab. So let me show you once the page is loaded. I'm going to click on these three ellipses on the right hand side. Notice here what it says. It says open in Chrome, powered by Chrome. So this is a plugin that one of the NativeScript community member wrote, and then I just used it. So I did not wanted to create my own page, embed a web view, and then take the URL of that news item and then open it up in the web view. So I wanted to, I noticed that today in Android, if you are looking at a particular app and then app has a URL, you click on that, it opens up something called as a custom Chrome tabs, I believe it's called as. So I'm using that. That's the functionality that I have. Right, so let me close this. And as you can see, this is what you can do with NativeScript. A bunch of things are possible. So sorry about this. I don't know why it's okay. Now it's again building it, so it's taking too much of time, because as I said, I'm running GoToMeeting. I have a lot of things going on, so looks like my mission is going slow. But I hope you got the idea. We have fantastic tutorial available here. If you go to nativescript.org, and there is this link which says NativeScript with Angular, and if you see here, it says get started with TypeScript and Angular. This is a fantastic tutorial created by my colleague. His name is TJ Vantall, and what this allows you to do is you will be creating this groceries app completely using NativeScript and Angular too, and then it walks you through step by step. It shows you how to create a UI, it shows you how to handle that sign-in button, it shows you how to handle that event, it shows you how to get the data from the server side, and then how to bind it to the list. You click on a list, you do something. So complete stuff is available here. I'm super excited to be you know, kind of playing around with NativeScript and Angular 2. As I said, I never did too many work on Angular 1.x, because I stayed away, because I did not like a couple of things there. But Angular 2 is so native for me. Like, you know, I feel as if like I'm working on a oops world. It has a component, I can create a component, a particular component can inject another component. You know, all those concepts are pretty nice. And NativeScript, if you want to create a native mobile app and you already know JavaScript or Angular 2 or TypeScript, well, this is the you know, framework that you will need to know to create a native mobile app, which gives you the native performance, native UI, but you don't have to learn iOS or Android. So let me see if it's built. So yeah, it's compile, it's done. Okay, I have a error, so sorry about that. So it's throwing up some errors. I'm not sure what has gone wrong. So as you can see here, let me try doing it again. But I hope you got the idea. And then if you go to nativescript.org, we have certain sample apps available. And if you click on developers, and I believe it's in the document, or sorry, it's in the resource list. If you go to nativescript.org, the main site, on the top, there is a resources list here. And if you click on this, we have bunch of sample apps, and there are videos also, you know, NativeScript getting started, and NativeScript snacks is something that a lot of snippets and then small 5-minute videos are available, and built-in app tutorial, build an app tutorials, as you can see here, bunch of tutorials, Angular mobile with NativeScript, so there you go. And then books, presentation slides, published apps. So this is what I was talking about. If you take a look at the showcase NativeScript apps, we have a bunch of things being showcased. Well, there's a question, what do we use as a backend, right? So it's up to you. So this is the front end. So we can work with any, I mean, it's a typical mobile application with, if you have an API, you just ping the API, get the data, put it to the front end. That's all simple as that. So it's up to you whichever backend you want to work with. So I can work with Azure, I can work with Firebase, I can work with, we have our own mobile backend as a service called as Telerik Connect, sorry, Everlive, what we have. So Telerik backend is what we have as a backend as a service. So it's up to you whichever backend that you want to work with. So this is a front end, this is a mobile application. So what we are trying to solve here is cross-platform mobile application, meaning write only once but get it to all the platforms. And these are some of the community written applications using NativeScript, as you can see here. So bunch of application have been showcased here, and you can take a look at it, and then you know, all those things. Plus I believe we have, there is a Slack channel. I'm available on Slack channel if you want to you know, be there, ask questions. Bunch of guys are there who help you, will help you out there. If you want, NativeScript is open source, so it's available on GitHub. You can always go there and then you know, contribute, or if you have an issue, you can raise an issue. Stack Overflow, we also have NativeScript news. If you want to put ideas for NativeScript, you can always do that. And blogs, you know, our team keeps writing everything about here with the for the NativeScript. So I would say get started. Now you don't need to sit back thinking like, oh, I don't know iOS or I don't know Java, I cannot be a mobile app developer. You don't need to. All you need to do is just get through these you know, tutorials that we have, and you will be able to create a native mobile app with whatever skills that you have. And these are some of the showcases as I showed you. And we also have certain examples here. You know, if you see here, it's showing the groceries. And you can subscribe to NativeScript newsletter here. I think I've gone overboard. It's 1:16 now by my watch. So I hope you got an idea as to what NativeScript is, what Angular 2 is, and then how can you, you know, pretty much start with Angular 2 knowledge and build native mobile applications. So I'm going to stop recording now and then get on to the Q&A. So thank you very much for all of you for attending this particular webinar. I hope you learned something new today, something cool today, and then we will be able to, I hope you will be coming back again for future webinars.